excited. We are on episode number 3 of my Pillow Talk Relationship Series. So come on in. Come on in. Join the Belleved crew. Hey Belleveds, welcome back to my channel, a space used to inspire, motivate, and enlighten others using my own life lessons, challenges, and experiences to help make a difference in this world. I've decided to do this episode podcast styled. It just seems so natural to me, you know. Hope you all don't mind. It may stay or it may not. I'm uncertain at this time. This is episode number 3. If you are new to my channel and enjoy this video or any of my videos, please subscribe below and click the notification button so you won't miss any of my upcoming Pillow Talk Relationship Series episodes. Single women of God, ladies, sis, madame, mademoiselle, this one is for you, my dears. This one is for you. As noticed from the topic, okay, girl, he popped the question and I said yes. Now the question is, will you say yes too? Some of y'all are probably like, huh? Don't you worry, sis, it will all make sense by the end of this video. All right, by the way, stick to the end to hear the story on this he popped the question shirt that I'm wearing, okay? All right, so this video is designed with lots to share with you all. I mean lots. I have messages from God and other things that is dwelt towards helping prepare for a divine marriage, aka kingdom marriage, if you will. Some people know it as that. All right, so let's jump right into it. First, I have a message for the single women of God who are tired, frustrated, and dismayed, who believe that they are a great catch, wife material, but is still single. And often ask themselves, why am I still single? Or, God, what's going on? God wants you to know something. He wants you to know nothing is wrong with you in this case, sis. Okay? He wants you to know that the reason some of you are single, are still single, is because, are you ready for this? Because you know too much. Yes, you know too much. All right, so what do I mean by this? I know some of you are like, what? I know, it sounds a little bit conceited, you know it all situation, but stay with me on this, okay? Just stay with me on this. It will make sense. You don't know it all in the conceited way as if you're the ish type, you know what I mean? But because in life, sis, and heartbreaks, you've been through it. You've been around it. You went below it. Now, you're above it with no longer heartbreaks, but with healing. Okay, so ever hear the saying, the more you know, the more accountable you're held? Well, you know too much as far as past causes and consequences based on experiences you've encountered. Therefore, sis, you know better, okay? You recognize better, and so for that reason, you do better. Which results to you thinking better. And that's why, sis, you're still single, because of the newfound mindset and motive. You've evolved beautifully and therefore make better decisions in which the options you've once recognized before as being good, you now recognize as simply not being for you. Okay? Does that make sense? So with all that being said, you've obtained strength, sis. You have wisdom to move away from what's not for you to now waiting for what is for you. And that's what this episode is about, okay? And whilst you wait, you don't just date, you elevate in this sense, okay? What does that mean by that? This is deep. You don't date, you elevate, okay? You elevate in the sense where if your energy alone doesn't get a man aroused, then you deemed he weren't the one for you. If your spirit didn't uplift him, then you put the connection down. If your intellectual mind didn't help him think deeper, then you told him, don't mind you. If your passions and your purpose didn't move him, you simply asked him to move past you. If you didn't help him evolve, then you just didn't involve with him. And if your love didn't open his heart, then you just asked him to simply not fall for you. Congratulations to you, sis. You're well on your way to positioning yourself for your divine marriage. I applaud you because despite all your challenges and possible judgment up against you, you stood strong, which leads me to share one of my quotes with you. Okay, it's significant in this case. All right, it goes like this. Your love is like abstract art, incomprehensive to some, but beautiful to him. Him being God, because he created you and he understands you like nobody else's. So again, congratulations. Now, moving along to me and my proposal, something I'm sure you've all been waiting to hear, okay? I know you've been waiting to hear. You're like, what is going on here? Girl, just grab your pillow, okay? Because I'm about to tell you all about it. All about it. So, God first proposed and popped the question in preparation for my own divine marriage. And he's asked that I share this with you all, single women of God. Okay, his question and proposal is this. Will I, or in our case, will we be his PPP woman? I know all of you are like, what is a PPP woman? Well, I'm glad you asked because I certainly found myself asking God too when he first brought this to me. I was like, what? What's a PPP woman? Okay, a PPP stands for Potential Patience Partner. Potential Patience Partner. His proposal to us is if we live in our full potential with patience, we will be sure to eventually meet our purpose partner. That's what the PPP is, okay? Potential patient partner. So what does a PPP woman of God looks like, you ask? Glad you ask. You're asking such good questions. The beautiful thing about agreeing to be a PPP woman of God in preparation for her divine marriage is this. The self-satisfying woman we become in the process, okay? As one of my favorite quotes says by Mark Nepo, the flower doesn't dream of the bee. It blossoms. Then the bee comes. You're that flower, sis, in this sense. And I'm about to fill you all in on what waiting on your bee, or your bae, rather, looks like. All right, so you're a flower and you're waiting for your bee or your bae. And let me show you what it looks like, okay? Let me break this down to you. Can you tell I'm having fun with this? I'm loving this very much so. All right, so let's start with the first P. First P, potential. Okay, this is the first P of being a PPP woman of God. God proposes that we live in our full potential for our divine marriage. So what does that look like? Well, it involves not just doing things that take steps towards our purpose, but takes care of ourselves. That includes mentally, spiritually, physically, and financially. Some examples of caring for our mental includes one, decrease and manage stress. That includes staying away from whatever may be negative and toxic to you. All right, sis? Two, get preventative therapy or counseling on matters that may be bothersome to you. Just like with any of our regular yearly physical exams, it is quite all right to speak with a therapist, you know, just because. Nothing need to happen to you. Nothing need to be wrong with you. It is all preventative measurements, just like with any other physical exam. And number three under the mental includes do something you enjoy. Travel, learn a craft, sing karaoke, swim with the dolphins, take a walk in the park, whatever you enjoy, sis, do it. That's what rejuvenates you, then do it, okay? Now, three examples of caring for our spirit includes 1, reading spiritual books, such as the Bible, going out and listening to spiritual individuals at conferences. 2, connect with nature. Walk barefooted on the beach or even hug a tree. 3 is recite or write words of affirmations to yourself. Place them in your car or your mirrors at home, wherever it's more accessible to you and that you could see it. Words of affirmation helps with just letting you remember your worth and knowing who you are and that you are loved. All right, now 3 examples caring for our physical. Okay, one of my favorites. You want to obtain good diet and exercise habits. 2, if you're looking to start a family, sis, you know, take your vitamins, especially your prenatal vitamins. You don't have to be pregnant, y'all. Ladies, remember, you do not have to be pregnant to take prenatal vitamins. I once thought that myself, and I was like, wait a minute. This is just vitamins, just an overload of vitamins. All right. Also, you know, take your folic acid and your biotin. All right. Biotin helps with getting great hair, skin, and nails. And, you know, of course, you want to consult with your doctor on all of those things that I mentioned. Okay. All of those things, consult with your doctor. Because I don't want anybody going to take stuff and say, hey, Belleve said to take this. Consult with your doctor, please, 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 please. All right, 3 under the physical is, okay, don't laugh at me, y'all. Do not laugh at me. Let's not forget to keep Virginia clean. Now, we all know who Virginia is. Let's not forget Virginia, y'all. Let's keep her right, keep her tight, keep her ready, and keep her blessed. Not blessed, blessed. So we want her to be ready and set. Just take a good care of her, okay? And just have a glowing body for Bae, because like I said, when Bae comes, you just want to be right. All right, so 3 examples of caring for your financial. Another favorite of mine, because it's very important. Very, very important. All right, so 1 under the financial is to clear your debt and fix your credit. Okay, we all know how important that is. Try to get out of debt little by little, slowly but surely. We're all going to get there, right? 2 is save money and limit excess spending. Okay, save money and limit excess spending. 3 is, all right, so if you are someone who isn't the greatest at saving, something I've done before is open a savings account in a different state and have a set amount of money, okay, direct deposited into the account every pay period. This is a savings account. Like if you go on vacation somewhere and simply open a savings account, but don't request for an ATM card. Right. The idea of this is to have difficulty accessing the account whilst having money continually going into there. It's a great, great way of saving, and it allows for discipline as well. So get a savings account in a different state, have your direct deposit go in there, set amount of money every so often. Moving on to the second P, patience. Second P is patience. God proposes that we live with patience for our divine marriage. Now, what does that look like? It's many things. We should, as women of God, be in continual prayer, all right, for our divine husbands. As with episode 2, remember when I mentioned what does women want from men? Well, we want to continue praying for God that He brings us a masculine man of integrity, all right, one who will protect, secure, provide, and lead us within the marriage, okay? All right, the second thing we want to do in the patience category is be content with being alone, okay, for the time being. Be content with being alone for the time being, sis. Enjoy your singleness, all right? This helps us learn ourselves while also makes us more productive and striving at living our highest potential, all right? So be content with being alone. It won't be for long, girl. You know, it's good woman season, so it won't be for long. You're going to get taken, okay? This is just all steps to take before you get into that divine marriage. All right, so that number three under patience is learn to master your craft. This is another favorite of mine. Whilst you're being single and enjoying your singleness, learn to master your craft. What does that mean by that? Your feminine craft. Learn to master your craft. This consists of boosting your creativity, right? While also remaining calm, cool, and collected. Your divine husband, I'm sure, will like his wife to withhold feminine qualities about herself, right? One that is peaceful, one that is soft-spoken, gentle, kind, sweet. So ease off of the masculine energy, sis, and stay within your feminine energy, okay? Nurturing is what we do best as a woman, all right? It is a beautiful thing, a beautiful blessing to be a woman. So try to leave the masculine energy for the man where it belongs, okay? Because let me tell you, I don't want to be masculine. I want to be feminine, you hear me? I don't have time for the whole masculine thing. It's too much work. So we're not trying to be perfect. It's more about trying something new. A new day with a new way, new motives, new mindsets, and simply a new you, right? We are improving us. We are evolving. And that's what this is all about, evolving and doing great things before getting our bee, in this case, our bae, because we're the flower and the bee gonna come, remember? You're the flower and your bee is going to come. So what you want to do is blossom before the bee comes. Just simply blossom. All right, so patience is indeed a virtue within many blessings at hand, and we want to gain all of which is owed to us. All right, so if you have some good patience, you eventually will get all that's owed to you, sis. So do not be dismayed. Do not feel like you're all lost cause, okay? You are single for a reason. You know, God is working on you, and God is doing good things in your life, okay? That's simple as that. Don't beat up yourself on this, okay? I hope all of you are enjoying. Let's see. So number three of the P is, well, the third P, I should say, is partner. We're coming to the juicy part that I love. This is the juicy part, y'all. God proposes that we will get our purpose partner if we agree to be a PPP woman, but what should this purpose partner look like? And how would we recognize him? Okay. How in the world are we going to recognize him, God? Okay. We're doing all this work, and how are we going to know when he is who he shall be? Okay. Who is going to be the man on the throne? How are we going to know? So here's five things that may be identifiable to you. Okay. Five things to identify a purpose partner is: one, he will be a man of God after God's own heart. A man of God after God's own heart. That's number one. Number two, he will practice what he preaches. So he'll be a man of integrity. As we said, like in episode number two, man of integrity. That's what women want. All right. Number three, under what your purpose partner may look like, he'll respect you, sis. He'll respect you, and he won't corrupt your good character. Okay, he won't corrupt you. He'll respect you. Okay. Number four, he'll make sacrifices for you and be consistent in his chase and pursuit towards you. Now let me pause here a little bit, touch on this a little bit, about this chase and pursuit part, because I feel this needs a little bit of you know, touching on here. Sis, don't go chasing any man, please, okay? Don't go chasing any man. There's a saying, and I am not 100% sure if it is even totally correct, but it is said that when a man meets a woman, he immediately categorizes her into three categories. One, he will know if she's a woman to marry. Two, he'll know if she's a woman he wants to sleep with. Or three, he'll know if she's a woman to just be friends with. All right? And put her on the back burner until he decides what he wants to do with her. All right? So remember, you are the prize, okay? You are the prize and the men are the chasers. And for the most part, a man knows who and what he wants when he's ready for a wife. Okay? So don't go chasing. It's pointless. It's pointless. Here's what we need to do. I'm not saying that us women should play hard to get, but our position, right, is two things. It's only two things. Our position should strongly be to stay in our feminine energy, right? Number one, stay in your feminine energy. And number two is to show subtle interest towards the man. Yes. So instead of chasing, just show him some interest, all right? Because a man won't know to chase you unless he knows that you're interested, okay? Yeah. All right, so once you show that interest, then the man, that will give him the cue point for him to, that you're interested in order to pursue you, right? Which will allow him to be the chaser, because men still wants to know that you are interested in him, in them, before he makes a move. Now, don't get this mistaken. Men can still be sensitive and shy like any other human being. Yes, it could be sensitive and they could be shy. So that's why it's important to just show your interest and leave it as that and let him do the rest. So also remember, you are the destination, sis, not the stop along the way, not a hookup for him, okay? Nor are you a rebound that a man should want to be with shortly after breaking up with his ex. You want to be the type of woman that he will want to compare you to other women that he's been with. You want to be the one that he compares other women to. Okay, which means you will uphold a greatness about yourself that, you know, say for instance, you know, he starts dating Joanne, okay, and he'll be like, well, is Joanne like so and so? Is she like so and so? Was she this? Did she make me smile? Did she do this? Was she make me dinner? You know, any little thing. You want to be the one that he compares the woman to. All right. I don't know if that making sense here. Does that make sense? I hope so. All right. So let's see. According to one of my favorite life coaches, Marshawn Evans Daniels. Okay. She wrote this beautiful quote that I love. That I love, love, love. Every woman longs to be seen, selected, and significant. Okay. We want to be seen, we want to be selected, and we want to feel significant, okay? Which leads me to share one of my own quotes with you, all right? Don't be an option. Be the selection. Don't be an option. Be the selection. Meaning, instead of being seen as just an option, okay, amongst all the thousands of women that he has, you know, to choose from, position yourself, okay, respecting yourself, knowing yourself and your self-worth, and improving on yourself will all make you attractive to a man, okay? Let me say that again. Positioning yourself, respecting yourself, knowing your self-worth, and improving on yourself will all make you attractive to a man. Therefore, he's more likely to select you and only you amongst the line of thousands and thousands of women and options that he has, okay? And so the fifth thing of identifying a good purpose partner is this. He gets excited and wants to support your passions and your purpose. After all, God said he would be a purpose partner, right? So it would make sense that we both would be excited for each other's purpose then, right? You'll be excited for his, he'd be excited for you. And like I said, you've elevated enough to know that if your passions and your purpose doesn't move him, then you simply move past him. Simple as that. There's a sixth one. He will want to pray and meditate for you or with you. Okay, he wants to pray and meditate for you and with you. And likewise, you will want to also pray and or meditate for him as well. Because as I said in another quote of mine, there's no I in team, but there's we in empower. Again, there's no I in team, but there's we in empower. So let's pray and empower one another. Okay, that's what we're here for. And seeing everyone grow and glow. All right. Whew, that was a mouthful. All right, so as I promised, let me tell you about the story behind the shirt I'm wearing, okay? I was shopping at the store when I saw this shirt and the spirit told me to pick it up. I was like, what? But no man has popped a question to me, right? This would be absurd. This was when God boldly said, I am popping the question to you and I am proposing to you. So I did just as what he said. I picked up the shirt, all right? And it wasn't until later on, he then proposed to me on being a PPP woman of God. And that's, you know, and that I should also share this lovely information with my sisters. And so this, sis, is how I've come to share this beautiful experience and message to you. Okay, it's just amazing. It really is amazing. I hope you find it to be amazing as well. Okay, and of course, I said yes to being a PPP woman of God, to God's proposal. And so whilst I am not, let me repeat, because some of y'all was probably confused, right, thinking I'm engaged. Whilst I am not physically engaged, I am, however, spiritually engaged as a PPP woman of God, awaiting her purpose partner, or rather a single selected flower full of nectar waiting on her bee. I am a single flower full of nectar waiting on her bee. Child, I told y'all this would be hot and spicy. After all, at the end of the day, we are God's bride. And so it would make sense to be a PPP woman of God. So, few words of encouragement, y'all, before I close this video out. All right, I hope you've all had fun. I hope you've getting something from this, you know, if not one, two, three. But let me say this last part here. God is a God of principle, plan, and purpose, okay? If you operate within your full potential with genuine intentions, you're bound to receive the many blessings that you deserve from him. All right, he's bound to bless you, y'all. Please, no whining towards delays in your life, because in divine timing, God knows how to keep us climbing and blesses us double for our trouble. Okay, he'll bless you double for your trouble. Remember, you can be in the season where it's your time, but God determines when it's your turn, sis. Okay, so it may be your time, but wait your turn. Wherever life plants you, bloom with grace. Your purpose partner is coming, okay? Bloom with grace. It may be your time, but it's not your turn. So until then, bloom with grace and he's coming. Sometimes it's not prayer that we need, okay? It's discipline, okay? God already told you what to do. You know what to do. In some cases, you've just procrastinating and being stubborn. So God wants you to return to the plan and stick with the blueprint that he has specifically designed and significantly designed for you, sis. Okay, return back to the plan. You know what to do. Stop procrastinating. Stop being stubborn. And just do what he asks you to do. Stick with the plan. Everything will flourish beautifully. With all that being said, woman of God, if you don't want to say yes to being a PPP woman of God, at least be another kind of PPP woman, that is to keep positive, okay? Be patient and stay persistent, okay? And that's all she wrote, y'all. That is all she wrote. I hope this episode has been a blessing to you all. Until next episode, stay belleyoutiful, stay blessed, and more importantly, say yes. Love y'all.